Taking off the gloves, I've had enough, it's in my blood. I was born for this.
Welcome to Week 11, guys. Joseph Robert, aka Joe Camo here, the fantasy football counselor, talking about Week 11 starts and sits, getting you guys fully prepared for a massive Week 11. As we approach fantasy football playoffs, this is a must-win for a lot of people. I'm going to get you guys prepared. We're going to be talking about all of the optimal players at each position, starting with quarterback, moving on to tight end, wide receiver, ending it with running back. Guys, I'm super excited. Week 11 is here. I cannot believe we're 11 weeks in. Just did a show with Tom Santinelli yesterday on the Week 11 preview. Go back and check that out. And of course, guys, leave your starts and sits questions below. Smash the thumbs up. It really helps the channel. Below, smash the thumbs up. And of course, one last thing. I did start the Joe Camo Show. And I'm telling you guys, I'm beyond excited. I have some amazing interviews and people coming on the show. And it's been great. I had this one guy, he's a 19-year-old guy that ran a 4.14 and was showing on SportsCenter that his video went viral where he ran a 4.14 40-yard dash. Great show. UFC fighters on there. I've had Chris CJ2K Johnson on there. So go back, guys. Check out the Joe Camo Show. There's a link here below, or just simply go to iTunes, the Purple Podcast app on your phone. Head over there and head on over to Spotify. Follow there, the Joe Camo Show, J-O-E-K-A-M-O Show. You will enjoy this show, I assure you. And the last thing. Guys, Christmas is here. Go to manscaped.com. Use promo code SHOWERLINE. Save some money on a Manscaped Lawnmower 3.0 trimmer. Amazing product, guys. This thing will help you shave your balls without cutting yourself. Really great, solidly built product. Very solid. They've also got other male products like ball wipes and weed whacker for your nose hair, stuff like that. Everything you need, guys, under the tree. Get it for Christmas. No pun intended, you know, under the tree. You'll really like it. Manscaped.com. Use promo code SHOWERLINE. There's also a link here below. Or just if you're in the car, pull over and manscaped.com. Use that code, save some money. All right, starting off with the quarterback. Starts and sits this week. I'll tell you all the guys that have a good matchup and all the guys that have a rough matchup, but it's up to you guys to start the right person because sometimes they have a rough matchup, they still end up doing well. But I'm telling you on paper how it looks for everybody, okay? First one, Kyler Murray, great matchup. And again, I do a Saturday DFS show where I'll kind of go over this in a little more detail. But Kyler Murray, great matchup versus Seattle. He's playing tonight. I'm actually looking forward to tonight's game, genuinely. Thursday Night Football. We know that Kyler had the best of Russell Wilson the first time they played. Russell Wilson on a bit of a decline, you know, as of late, the past couple games. He's had a couple rough games. I'm going to say that it's going to be a redemption game. That's my prediction on this game. Seattle bounces back. Russell Wilson bounces back and puts himself back into that MVP discussion. So I'm telling you, man, it's going to be a huge game. A lot on the line for Russell Wilson because, again, Kyler Murray now making a statement. They had the huge win last week versus Buffalo with the Hail Mary pass to DeAndre Hopkins. And when you look at that, you're saying, okay, well, Kyler Murray's going to make a debate here for MVP. And if he ends up winning tonight's matchup, it might push Russell Wilson out. So it's a huge game. I think it's very important that Russell Wilson wins the game tonight, okay? And he does it convincingly. Pat Mahomes here, easy matchup coming off. Man, two red-hot weeks. He is playing the Raiders, pretty decent matchup. Russell Wilson also, like we said, has an easy matchup against Kyler. Got to mention that. Jameis Winston should be playing Atlanta. Good matchup for him. But again, he's coming in and he hasn't played right this year. It's been Drew Brees. So Jameis Winston coming in, Drew Brees out with a, as you guys know, rib injury, punctured lung. I don't know how long he's going to be out. Nobody knows. I would assume 2 to 3 weeks minimum. So Winston's going to come in and it could be one of those boom games, could be a bust game. We don't know. Very high risk, but the matchup is favorable. Big Ben, easy matchup this week, guys, versus Jacksonville. Just want to let you know, it is an easy matchup. Herbert, easy matchup versus the Jets. I mean, he's been pretty good every single week, so you may want to consider him, especially in DFS. Wacko Flacco, you can't trust him, but he does have an easy matchup. Alex Smith, easy matchup versus the Bengals. Lamar Jackson, Kirk Cousins. We talked about Russell Wilson. Carson Wentz, decent matchup. And Cam Newton, all decent matchups versus position. Guys that have it in tough, just to be aware here, Aaron Rodgers has it in tough. Toughest matchup versus position against Indy. Tom Brady. Every time I say Aaron Rodgers, I think Matt Ryan because I have them on this one team and I kind of alternate who to start. Tom Brady, second hardest matchup versus position versus the Rams. Other guys, Deshaun Watson got in tough. Phillip Rivers got in a little bit tough. Jared Goff got in a bit tough. Derek Carr and Ryan Tannehill have it in tough. Tannehill playing the Ravens. Just to keep this in mind, guys, I'm not saying don't start them in year long. What I'm saying is they've got it in tough. You need to be aware. Moving on to that boring tight end position. I mean, Taysom Hill, I mean, you could start him. Now, here's the deal. Some leagues, I heard Yahoo doesn't, but I heard some leagues you can start Taysom Hill as a tight end. Might be a viable play as he may get more work, may get a rushing touchdown, may get integrated into this offense a little bit more. So Taysom Hill is an option at tight end if you are desperate. He does have a favorable matchup versus Atlanta. They don't play tight ends well. So if you can plug in Taysom Hill and you do not have a better option, consider him, okay? But again, one of those boom-bust kind of plays. Jared Cook, easy matchup here for you. Logan Thomas, Washington versus Cincy. Easy matchup. You may want to consider him, okay? Coming off an 11-point week. Hayden Hurst, coming off a 13-point week. Pretty easy matchup. Keep him in mind, okay? Hunter Henry, pretty decent matchup. Hawkinson, hard to trust coming off last week, but he's got a pretty decent matchup as well. Hard to trust him. Let's move on here to the tough matchups. Robert Tonyan has it in tough versus Indy. Tyler Eifert has it in tough versus Pittsburgh. The Texans tight ends have it in tough versus New England. Not that they've done much in regards to Atkins and Fells. Haven't really been the most exciting bunch there. Mo Ali Cox, Jack Doyle have it in tough here versus Green Bay. Darren Waller got it a little bit tough versus KC. Keep that in mind here. And I think that's pretty much it. Travis Kelce, 10th hardest matchup for his position, just so you know. He is playing the Raiders. The Raiders do play tight ends tough.
I didn't get that.
But it's Travis.
Did you try again?
Siri's talking to me. Siri was talking to me as I'm recording. Okay. So Travis Kelce, again, how do you sit him? You cannot sit Travis Kelce at all, okay? I mean, again, tough matchup, but he's been hot the past couple weeks. Moving on to the wide receiver position here. Let's go to wide receiver. Who's got the optimal matchups for you? And with wide receiver, again, for DFS, take some risks, guys. Those guys that could have those breakout weeks, take some risks. Hopkins, great matchup. Coming off that red hot week and that big catch, great matchup. So does Christian Kirk and anybody on the Cardinals. But again, Hopkins being the number one target there. Also, now, Adam Thielen, Justin Jefferson coming off pretty decent weeks last week. Have a good matchup against Dallas. Very favorable for these guys. Look for them to have a boom type of game. Michael Thomas, who's been ice cold with a new quarterback under center with Winston. You know, I'm suspect here, but the matchup is favorable, okay? They are playing Atlanta. Just note that it's favorable. All of the wide receivers from Dallas have a favorable matchup, but it's a suspect situation with a suspect quarterback. I'm personally staying away from all those options. Travis Fulgham had a two-point game last time he played. Crappy game. Don't trust him, but it is a favorable matchup. All of the Eagles guys, they are playing Cleveland, have a favorable matchup. Keep that in mind. Marquise Brown has been absolute crap this week, this year. Him and Snead got a good matchup versus Tennessee. Terry McLaurin, been pretty hot, been pretty solid the past 3 weeks. 18 points last week, 28 the week before, 22 the week before that. McLaurin playing Cincy. Good matchup here for you, okay? The Steelers wide receivers, all top 10 last week in regards to fantasy points. Great matchup here, guys, for the Steelers. I'm telling you, Chase Claypool, Deontay, depends on who your gut feeling is saying is going to get the most volume. Start them up, okay? Also, Shark has a great matchup, although he hasn't been hot this year. Keelan Cole, all of the Jacksonville guys have a decent matchup against Pittsburgh secondary, but again, I don't really, really trust them at all, okay? Metcalf, Lockett, also good matchups, favorable matchups versus the Cardinals. Guys that have it in tough, Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, Antonio Brown, they are playing the Rams secondary. They have it in tough. T. Higgins and Tyler Boyd have it in a little bit tough versus Washington secondary. They've been playing wide receivers pretty tough. A.J. Brown, Corey Davis, right? A.J. Brown coming off a bad week last week or the week they played last. Terrible week. Hopefully they bounce back. They do have a tough matchup, though. Michael Pittman, tough matchup. All of the Indianapolis Colts have it in tough versus Green Bay secondary. Not the greatest rush defense, but pretty good secondary. Devontae Adams has been red hot, is playing Indianapolis, has it in a little bit tough. There may be a return of Alan Lazard. Keep a watch on him. I know a lot of people jumped on the waiver wire to get Marquise Valdez-Scantling, but understand Lazard may be returning, but they do have it in tough with around the eighth hardest matchup versus the position against wide receivers. Kenny Golladay, I think he's still out. They've got a relatively tough matchup. 11th hardest versus position when you're looking at Marvin Jones, Marvin Hall, or anybody from Detroit at the wide receiver position. They got it in a little bit tough. All right, let's round it out here with the running backs, okay? Everybody's favorite position, my personal favorite position, the position that's been, you know, beaten and bruised all season. So, Mike Davis, good matchup. And I think McCaffrey's going to be out. Davis has been mediocre at best the past 3 weeks, has not eclipsed 10 points in fantasy. So, I mean, he has a good matchup versus Detroit. You may want to consider him. And for DFS, $6,800, they understand. He's still expensive in DFS. They understand he's due for a big game. The matchup is favorable. And if CMC's out, he's going to eat. Mike Davis is a guy that you may want to start. All of the running backs in New England do have it in good against Houston, but who do you start? Do you start Harris? Do you start Burkhead? Burkhead had a decent week last time he played, but again, still very hard to trust. Indy, Jonathan Taylor. I mean, I don't know what to tell you. He's just not getting it done, not getting the volume that he needs. Nyheim Hines coming off that big game. They all have a good matchup this week. But do you trust Taylor? Do you trust Hines? I don't trust anybody. DeAndre Swift, red hot DeAndre Swift, who's been showing that he is possibly rookie of the year for running back, at least. This is a guy that came off a 26-point week. Seems to me, looking at the volume, that he is getting more volume. He is getting more work. He is the guy there in Detroit. I like that they're using the young talent. I like that they're phasing out Adrian Peterson. I like that they're getting the hungry guy in. That's what every team should do. Find the talent. Let them run, man. That's what they're there for. They're young, they're hungry. Let them run. Clyde Edwards-Helaire, also a good matchup, along with Swift. And again, he's had some mediocre weeks. Bell just been crapping the bed. He sucks. He's been doing more boxing, Le'Veon Bell, than he has been actually, you know, doing football. And yeah, I think Clyde Edwards-Helaire should get the volume there. Dobbins, Ingram, who do you start here? Disaster. Probably Gus Edwards is going to get some volume there. All good matchups, but again, I don't trust anybody here. James Conner, good matchup. Joshua Kelly and the Chargers got a good matchup versus the Jets. Dalvin Cook should run for 2,000 yards in one game. He is playing Dallas, but who knows? He had a mediocre game last week versus Chicago, but Chicago's not that good. Jacobs has a decent matchup as well, who's coming off a red-hot week and seems to find his momentum. Todd Gurley, tough matchup. These are tough matchups. He's got it in tough coming off a bye week playing the Saints. Got it in real tough. James Robinson, playing Pittsburgh, got it in tough. Be careful if you have him. Hopefully you have a better option. Alvin Kamara versus Atlanta. Pretty tough matchup versus the rush defense, but I would not sit Alvin Kamara. Aaron Jones, I believe he is playing. Him and Jamal and all those guys, they are playing Indy. They have it in tough. Be aware. Ronald Jones, Leonard Fournette, got it in tough. Miles Sanders, 10th hardest matchup versus position versus Cleveland, got it in tough. And Zeke Elliott, 11th hardest versus position, playing Minnesota. And that's it, guys. Starts and sits. Go back, listen to it again if you have to. Now, this is the thing. If you are starting somebody, you're trying to make a decision, you've got a lot of the optimal plays at each position. So you can make an executive decision on if or not you should start that person. Okay, so it's up to you guys to make that decision. And understand, guys, sometimes when they do have that favorable matchup, it may favor them. Sometimes they might just crap the bed either way. But at least you know if the matchup is favorable on paper, then you can make an executive decision whether you're trying to make a decision to start this guy or that guy. At least you know, hey, this guy's got a good matchup. I'm trying to decide, but this guy's got a better matchup. Maybe I'll go that guy because on paper it looks like it's a good matchup, okay? Good luck, everybody. Week 11 is upon us. Fantasy football, I can't believe fantasy football 2020 is coming down to almost playoff time. It's been crazy. Make sure you guys follow the Joe Camo Show. You got some homework here, guys. Joe Camo Show below. You'll really enjoy the conversations there. Genuinely, the guests have been amazing. Link below here, Joe Camo Show. Smash thumbs up here. Leave some questions below for starts and sits. And go to manscaped.com. Use promo code SHOWERLION. I assure you guys will be very happy with the trimmer. SHOWERLION is the promo code. Use it. Save yourself. I believe it's 20%. Head on over to manscaped.com right now. Thanks for being here, guys. NFL Week 11 preview predictions. All that stuff is in an episode before this, the predictions and stuff. So go back and we will talk soon, guys. Starts and sits for you. All done.